time is it here? 2:30? It's gonna be 3 soon. Damn, I gotta go to work already? It's like 6.5 hours. What shaking? No, 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 what? You can't feel shaking on the water! Water works, Klee. Holy shit, a cutscene. They made cutscenes for an event. Oh, what? I feel like I remember someone saying something about this. Shit. Dude, make a freaking movie, guys. Like, this looks great. I would watch a movie of this. The animations are fucking gorgeous. What we just witnessed was the birth of land. Oh my god, there's so much to explore again. There looks to be an arena over there. Yeah, there's a flat, like, arena-like platform in the middle of the... There is no water to launch your wave rider. Oh, shit. So what I basically have to do now is re-explore the whole fucking place. Oh, there's new islands, too, though. It's not just the existing ones. There's whole new islands. Okay. What happened to, like, the outposts? They're still out there, it looks like, but... Oh, man. Look, they made this. You know, how did they make this? Like, how did... I don't know, it just seems weird to me. I mean, no doubt the company behind this has a lot of money now. And had a lot of money, considering they were already running a game that was very popular. But still, I'm just under the impression that when comparing to other companies... So these guys are doing something different. They're doing something weird. They're somehow... Oh, shit. They're somehow, like, doing things. You know, like, actually doing something. And it's a free game, too. So, you know, that's what I love about... I mean, it's got gacha elements and shit, too, right? But from what I can tell, you don't have to touch them. Just like you don't have to touch the monetization in other parts of other games, either. But I love that the number one thing that you always get is, you know, a counter-argument you always get when a company is being the most egregious pieces of shit that they can ever be and charging $60 for a virtual pixelated tank... or plane. Oh yeah, but they're a business, so they gotta make their money. But then you got these guys over here who are handcrafting full-fledged regions for a limited time event that may, of course, I don't know if this stuff will stay, but still, they went through the effort of making this, and it's a free game, and it's not forcing me to spend money to play in the event, and it's not forcing me to spend money or giving me the implication that I should spend money on a pre-order for some sort of item just so that I can get some unique things that will never be available again, you know? So don't give me that fucking, well, it's a business bullshit. Yeah, it's a business, which is why I'm willing to spend money on this game more so than I always feel willing to spend money on a different game, because this game doesn't constantly shove something up my anus and make me basically sell my soul. I sold my soul to this game, but willingly. You know, they don't force me to sell my soul. Sorry, I needed to rant for a bit. Okay, so I gotta figure out how to explore these islands again. So we're basically gonna have to just re-explore everything. Any and everything new. Because I don't know where stuff is gonna be. Like, if we open up the map... Yeah, okay, the map is updated now. Oh my Jesus Christ. Well, there's new waypoints, though, so... That's neat. Actually, should we go do this first? Because... If I want to unlock the second tier of whatever the challenges are, that way while we're out exploring, I can already have access to like doing some of the outposts as we come across them. Then we'll come back and go through each one of these places. That'll work, yeah. Mm-hmm. I like that. We'll do that. Yep. Mm-hmm. Yes. Can I pick up that starfish? No. Alright, let's just follow the quest for a second. Right now. Dude, that horizon line is just so freaking epic looking. What is that over there? Wait, what is that over there? Oh my god! Is that Sin? Way over... What the fuck? There's stuff way off the ass end of the map here. Oh, there's stuff up there on that. Oh, look! Now there's an island up in that spot I said, why is there so much water but nothing's up there? Now there's an island up there. I want to go over to Sin. I want to touch it.
We called it Sin.
Ow, my head! Okay.
Ho wee yo, yo ho.
Oh, there's a waypoint here and everything. I can see it over there on the far side. That's pretty and colorful. My eyes are actually having a hard time adjusting to this color. I think it's because the sun's going down. Oh shit, there's something over there, though. I don't want to get too close and trigger it. Let me just get this first. Shazam. Is that worth primogems? Yeah, it is. There's a conch here. There it is. Hell yeah.
大人们都说你是从远方来的，打扮得像个将军。将军，你会和我说话吗？ 不行的话，我采的花送给你，总可以吧？
Who is this general they keep referring to? Dude, I don't want to fight. There's nowhere to heal up here. Like, no statue for me just to rely on. So there's bound to be a whole bunch of new conchs, which is how we're gonna finish off. I don't exactly know if you have to get close to the conch for it to show up on the map. Yeah, so yeah, it just showed up on the mini-map now. So you have to actually get close to the region, or close to it in the region. Elsewise, I won't even know it's there. No, can't break those. Wait, this one's hidden. Jeez.
妈妈说你根本不是我们的同伴，但你就是保护了我们呀，对吧，将军？我忘了你不跟我说话。妈妈还说我们和将军你一样，我们的故乡也在很遥远的地方，远到想不起来那是哪里。将军，你会想家吗？
Homeland, added to Conk. Oh, that's also part of my meme thing, the way that I pronounce certain words purposefully. Like, Conk, I guess, could be in there. Like, I always, instead of saying anomaly, I always say anomalous purposefully. Instead of debris, I say debris, because it's just stupid. I find stupid funny. Alright, I don't know what that is, and it looks kind of scary. Like, it might fuck us up the ass, because... yeah, alright, hello! What the hell? An Oni mask? It resembles a human, but something's not quite right. I don't remember what blue stands for. Doesn't, like in Chinese culture, doesn't the different colored masks stand for certain types of personalities? Oh, that's cute. It's a ploy.
看起来对方没有要理睬可莉的意思呢。
Yeah, let's go touch it. Why not?
没有反应，应该是已经损坏了。It's
got a sword on it.
只是猜测，它跟海岛的整体气氛格格不入。看衣着，倒像是从稻妻漂流而来。
Oh, so totally Japanese then. Okay, so it is an Oni mask. Because Inazuma, I believe, is the Japanese-themed region that is supposed to be coming out soon, apparently. It's an electro-themed region, which I think is going to be oh so freaking epic. I cannot wait to see what it looks like. Because I think the color purple is going to look gorgeous, and I wonder what type of architecture they're going to use.
是的，这里是独立的海域，不跟任何国度接壤。对这片海洋而言，它也是异乡人。
但一到期眼下的情况，就怎么会发生这种事？没反应的异乡人，好神奇！是有人把他带来这里吗？啊，大魔王不动了。可莉，也许大魔王只是累了。对对，大魔王应该是睡着了吧？等你等得不耐烦，就呼的睡过去了。嗯，我们陪可莉去别处玩。 等大魔王睡醒再来找他。哦，真的？当然啦，你要相信我们。嗯，不对，可莉想到了，这个不是大魔王，真正的大魔王还在别的地方。哎，是吗？哼，可莉不会放弃，大魔王等着吧，我们来找你。
Oh, by the way, guys, another thing I wanted to mention was that quest we did for Klee right before starting this event that I thought was part of this event, like when we had to go find her buried treasure, and I said, what, they made that treasure, like, you know, many months back, and then... And did they pre-plan for the event or whatever I said? Apparently, no. I actually did Klee's story quest. So a lot of the characters have story quests that you need keys to access. But apparently, the devs made that particular story quest accessible to everyone. You don't need keys so that you can do the event, and you have to do it for the event. So I unknowingly did Klee's story quest, basically, which is why there was like that mini continuity thing that I wasn't assuming, because it had been released, I think someone said, 7 months ago, that quest was. So just thought I'd point that out to acknowledge that people were telling me about it. My hero is done. Check rewards. I think we get one at none. Yeah, we get one more conch, will give us some more juice. So where does the quest want us to... Oh, it wants us to examine the environs. That's totally epic, dude. At first, I thought it looked Japanese, but I remember I just recently learned that, like, in Chinese plays and stuff, masks, different colored masks, apparently tell you what type of personality a character has. Like, green, I think, means aggressive, if I remember correctly. I don't remember what red, blue, and etc. are. But I also immediately thought that this looked like something very Japanese-themed. And sure enough, it comes from Inazuma, so, which is supposed to be the Japanese territory. Or Japanese-inspired territory, I suppose. And there's supposed to be other territories as well that people were talking about. I know I've already talked about this, but I cannot wait to see them. Oh my god, it's gonna... And at least I don't have to wait a full year for one new state to be added, like an American Truck Simulator. Because, I don't know, I think it'll be exciting. I'm examining my environs. How do I use that eyeball thing again? Is that V? No. I forgot what you... This. What do I press for that? Do I... Middle mouse? Okay, it's middle mouse. I don't think they want me to do that anyways. I'm not going to use my witcher senses. It's a whole bunch of rocks.
好像是在纪念某个人，说的我都不好意思了。可这附近只有那个没反应的到期机械而已呀。难道是在纪念他？或许，他也曾做出过值得他人纪念的事。我们所见到的这些布设，足以证明这片海域中有人类存在过。可光凭这些。 无法推导究竟是怎样的人类文明。迄今为止，我们也没有见到任何人类或是人类的物种。新团长，可莉去那边看看可以吗？可以，务必注意安全。
I have got to add Klee to our collection. She is so fucking adorable. Okay.
How many secrets do these islands hold?
可莉还小，比较缺乏危机感。但旅行者，我希望我们都能清醒地了解现状。
坦白说，一开始我以为那封信只是恶作剧。我们也这么想，我也是。可会是谁给这样的小孩子寄恶作剧信件呢？知道这座岛屿
Not one as elaborate, at least.
引导我们解开机关更是布局巧妙。说不定，这些不是恶作剧，而是谋划已久的陷阱。我们绝对不能掉以轻心。芭芭拉姐姐，可莉，怎么了？
你说，大魔王会不会不想见可莉？为什么呢？因为嘟嘟可喜欢可莉，可莉也喜欢嘟嘟可，大魔王没法把我们分开，就只能不见我们。可莉很怕他把我们分开。啊！可莉看，这是什么？啊，是羽球。我听起。 听琴团长说过，可莉一直想玩羽球，对不对？对，可莉想过羽球节。这是我为可莉做的特制羽球。只要可莉想玩，天天都是羽球节，好不好？Do
I smell a mini game incoming?
所以可莉，打起精神来。Also,
she's good with children. That's great.
我们大家都会帮你说服她，让她允许你和嘟嘟可在一起。
I'm that type of person, like, if you hand me a baby, I'll be like, oh, okay, cool, now what? Because I don't freaking do well with children, they're weird. They're stinky little things, and they look like naked mole rats. Let's double our efforts.
We have to find him.
Dramatic zoom in.
惑的。就算不知道什么时候才能找到，不知道在哪里才能找到，也总会找到的吧。嗯，在那之前就先到附近尽情搜索吧。
Midsummer Island Vacation Adventure, I mean. Oh, we're done with that. Okay, so now we're on to part three.
Okay.
Observe the direction of the wind to steer your wave rider along the correct course. Activate mechanisms and sail your way through the whirlpool off to starboard full speed ahead challenge. This challenge is divided into seaborne and airborne courses. Your final score will be based on the amount of time taken to complete the challenge and the number of wave splitter insignias collected. Navigate using your wave rider to collect as many wave splitter insignias as possible. Navigate your wave rider through wavefront girdles to gain a short speed boost. Collect charge particles to charge up your wave rider's accelerate ability. Floating towers manned by monsters may appear along your course. More wave splitter insignias will appear alongside the course if you defeat the monsters.
Ew.
Wait, what? Oh, so it's a whole different type of minigame. It's not just more defeat enemies like the previous one. We've unlocked this shit. Whirlpool off to starboard, full speed ahead. Okay, so we got the bronze. It looks like, okay, so... Oh, and again, look, it's just like the other events, too, that we did. Oh my god, there's so many of them. It's just like the other ones. Remember where... You only had to beat the easy version to get the best, like the primigems, and then the later tiers you didn't have to feel forced to do because they didn't give you primigems or anything. I like that they give you the arguably the more important reward for just at least participating. You know, that's also something that I appreciate. But we'll try to do all three if we can, because I ain't gonna complain about 30,000 extra mora. It looks basically the same all the way through. Okay. And then this is the third quest here that we gotta do. So now I can go around and explore, and on the way, we can do some of these little challenges. Oh, okay, so there are these things. Fishy sea breeze, wave breaker, racing rhythm. So these are each of the different ones, I guess. Rough water rush, skipper's savvy. Oh, look, see? It's like its own little area that you can flip back and forth between. See, that's kind of how you can do it. Although, to be fair, I do hope that some regions are interconnected to, like, the current ones we already have in the game. Because I would like to be able to see from one point to the other point, and that'd be really epic. Now... This is definitely something we're going to have to fight. I can bet you that 100%. Because it's too detailed to not have to fight it. It's in a freaking flat arena. They want us to go to the top of a freaking mountain over there. Alright, let me see. What time is it? It's probably... Okay, it's 3. I might play until 4. That would give me 5 hours. That would give me an extra hour to play here. And then I'd have some hours to explore another game that I wanted to play. I wanted to look at those boating things again just to see if they're the same names. Yeah, fishy, skippy, savvy. Okay. Or skipper's savvy. So we can try these as we come to them. Whoops. As we come to them. But what I'm going to do now is we're going to start exploring the actual islands. Like fully this time. And unfortunately, it looks like the next quest is right where I need to teleport. Hopefully this doesn't trigger the quest. No, okay. Good. Very, very good. Sehr good. I try to explore this as best as possible here. Oh, I see multiple chests and stuff. Oh, this place is gonna be worth a lot of loot. Right here, white iron chunks. I do think, though, I don't think a lot of people agree with me on this, but I do, I would, if you want me to request, like, the number one thing that I will request from the devs to do. Put a mining minigame in the game, please. Put a minigame where I can mine rocks. Not just by whacking them with a sword, mind you. I mean, like, a full-on built minigame. I gotta have mining in everything. Something super tedious. It just makes me moist. And I think we're gonna switch... What? Oh, I pressed I. I don't know why I tried opening an inventory like I was playing a different game. I'm actually gonna put Chi-Chi away, and I'm gonna bring out Dailuke for a second. Because he is one of those characters that has the ability to do something like this without literally killing my character. So I'm gonna keep him on for just our explorative reasons right now, which is weird because he's a dude, and I pretty much haven't touched any guys in this game before. Though a lot of people keep telling me that he's a really good character, so I should try to invest someday. I would like to invest in all my characters. That way I can have a full-fledged... And see, that's another thing. That's why I would also like to have a new game plus, because then I can explore the whole game from the get-go again with all my characters, but have a completely different party set up. You know, play through the game with dudes instead, or something like that. I think that would be a lot of fun. Alright, now I gotta be really careful with how I'm exploring here, because it looks like you can easily miss stuff. Well, there's a chest here. Huh. There's a box on the ground. Once you have entered the painted ground, your normal attacks will be changed to the Dodo Guard. You can use the Dodo Guard to return Windblessed Harpasta, whatever that is. Throw Windblessed Harpasta and hit the Dodo King's painted wall to begin the challenge. Use your Dodo Guard to return the Windblessed Harpasta and strike the Dodo King's painted wall. Once you accumulate a certain number of hits, you can destroy the wall and obtain the corresponding rewards. So this is that ball thing. So it's basically Blitzball. Hell yeah, so we got Sin and Blitzball here, huh? Well, Jeezy said normal attacks will be transferred into... Well, hello, what am I supposed to be doing here? The camera's locking. Oops. What? What am I doing wrong? Do I need to read it again? No, what? I keep running out of it on accident. Where's the help desk? Where are the events? There. I don't think, is there anything in here that lets me? Oh, is that what these are? These mini harpostums? Is that how you get these points? I thought it would just be for the chest. Wait, I don't have a ball. Do I need a ball first in order to play these? I wonder if that's the case, because I noticed with the quest, if you look at the event quest that we got to do, event details. If you look at the number 3 here, never mind. I thought it said I got a ball for that. I could have swore one of the quests said that you get that there was a ball in it as one of the rewards. Maybe it wasn't this. What? Story quests. Oh, I don't see Klee's story quest in here. It says claim. What am I claiming? Oh, that's so I can claim. Right, I can claim more daily quests. Or keys, I mean. Yeah, I don't see Klee in here. Strange. Oh, I don't know. It's a story for another time, I guess. Figure that out. Maybe you don't need balls? What if I try a character that has a sword? No, she just swings it as per normal. Huh, okay. Weird. Well, the only thing that's confusing me is that I could have swore that it said that one of the upcoming quest rewards was a ball. So I thought maybe, you know... Well, okay, here's what we'll do. When we come across these, I'll mark them on the map. That way... I don't know what to mark it with. Here, I'll mark it with that. That way I know where these are so we can come back to them when I actually do figure out what the fuck I'm doing. Alright? Because it seems like a fun little mini game, but... I don't know how to actually access it yet. But right now, I kind of want to just explore a little bit, and then we can continue the main shit. Motherfucker. No, you don't. This guy's not too... hard compared to some of his buddies. Just keep an eye open for any kind of loot because, like, I gotta keep an eye up there too because there's bound to be more stuff on the sides of these rock walls. Oh no, there's a big motherfucker. And he's protecting a chest. Alright. Okay. Let's, see how... Is he hard to kill? Well, he's got some health. I don't remember exactly what this guy... Okay. Noted. Oh, he be hurting. I'm trying to make sure that I keep him right here next to the chest, because the last thing I need is for him to get his health fully regenerated because I stepped away. Alright, we got him. You. 5 more primigems. You. It's fun, ya. Yeah. Except now Hu Tao's almost dead and Dialuke's taking up my room for heals. What is that blue thing? Sea... what? A plant species that only grows in certain regions and islands of the ocean. Though it looks something or other. Well, fuck, it's gorgeous. I want it. I'm taking all of them. Also, I didn't pick up that... fucking crab! I didn't take the flow flow. I'm gonna be using a lot of Ganyu, I think. Just because Hu Tao is currently under the weather. Oh my god, what the hell? I guess the other guy just didn't care about my thing. How do you guys feel today? I like that we're getting primigems for opening the chest, too, just like any normal explorative region. Because it means that I'm walking away with more primigems for our pulls that I want to do. See, and now I can also do this. Instead of killing myself just to grab a flower, I can use Dialuke here to just yoink, and then yoink, and then get frozen, and then yoink. Actually, he is almost dead. Never mind. I take that back. He almost died. I don't even know what almost killed him. I guess getting frozen almost killed him. What is the floating loophole over there? Dude, I gotta pee really bad. I'm gonna have to do that.
I'm here.